Now, hopefully this is just a bit of revision from GCSE, but there are three types of variable that we have in an experiment. First of all, we have the independent variable, and this is the thing that you decide to change. And when you change something, it causes something else to change, and this is what you can measure, and this is what we call the dependent variable. But in order to kind of really understand what's actually having this effect, you need to keep other things the same. These are the control variables, and they allow you to make sure it's a fair test. So hopefully that's just a little bit of a reminder. So let's think about a real-life example, perhaps maybe a pendulum that's oscillating backwards and forwards. So maybe you're testing a pendulum, and maybe something that you want to change is the length of the pendulum from the pivot to the centre of mass. So maybe this thing here, the length, is what you decide to change. That means my independent variable is my length. What I could then do is use a stopwatch to work out how long it takes for one oscillation. So it might be that my dependent variable then is the time period. And I'd actually find that out not by measuring the time for one oscillation, but the time for 10, doing it a number of times, and then taking an average, dividing it by 10 to find my dependent variable. So what things do I keep the same? Well, I might keep the same mass on the end of the bob to make sure it's a fair test. And also maybe release it from the same angle theta each time. And by doing that, I ensure that the thing that changes the time period isn't the mass on the end, it isn't the angle that it's swinging through, but it's purely the length. So hopefully that's a little bit of revision. It's not too bad, but I think the challenge is really when you apply it to new different experiments and actually try and work out for the new experiments which is your independent dependent, and then some good control variables that actually ensure that fair test.